Hello everyone, my name is Vincent Hill. I'm a display reviewer. In this video, I would like to talk about the latest firmware update Sony has released for its VW760 4K laser projector, which is also marketed as the VW885 in the USA. The Sony VPL-VW760ES was launched more than 2 years ago, so it's good to see the Japanese manufacturer continuing to support it, instead of just launching a new model with basically the same specs. Normally, I would be standing beside the projector when filming this video to show that I have indeed tested the projector, but it just so happens that the review sample is in my old test room, and because the UK is in lockdown, I am only allowed to make essential trips or travel to work. I'm still awaiting clarification on whether the ability to adjust keystone qualifies me as a key worker. Anyway, our Sony VW760 review unit was loaded with firmware 8.102, the latest at the time we filmed this video in April 2020, which adds a number of picture quality features. The originally latent mechanical iris has now been unlocked, allowing for dynamic iris functionality that works together with laser dimming to deepen blacks and boost contrast performance in low light scenes. On the whole, it worked well. Although, as is the case with most dynamic iris systems, some pumping artifacts were visible, especially on the more aggressive dynamic control full setting, causing a jarring dip and then elevation in black level during this fade to black transition from the Revenant. Note that engaging dynamic control would also increase near black gamma and make shadow detail look darker than reference. Unfortunately, Sony has decided to lump both laser dimming and dynamic iris under one single dynamic control setting. Perhaps the company can consider providing separate controls for laser dimming and dynamic iris to achieve greater refinement. One can only hope. The next feature added by firmware 8.102 was Digital Focus Optimizer, which was previously only implemented on the step-up VW870. Aiming to compensate for blurriness at the periphery of the lens. Based on our test, enabling Digital Focus Optimizer would apply sharpening around the edges of the picture, as you can see from an increase in moire in the corners. Some of you may have noticed random spots of blotchiness scattered throughout the Luma zone plate pattern. This was caused by Sony projector's automatic zone correction for convergence and pixel alignment errors. Fortunately, the zone convergence correction algorithm can be disabled from the service menu, ideally by a trained personnel, which would then return a clean Luma zone plate pattern. Firmware 8.102 also allowed for independent SDR and HDR settings on the Sony VPL-VW760ES. Previously, most settings including brightness and color are shared between SDR and HDR. But with the latest firmware update, you can enjoy optimal settings for SDR and HDR respectively. Note that the values shown in this video are for illustration purposes only. Please don't copy them as proper calibrated settings for your specific unit. There have been some changes to the HDR tone mapping in firmware 8.102, particularly when coming out of black, so you get a more balanced picture with improved shadow detail. The lapel on Hugh Jackman's jacket and the crowd in the shadows during Jenny Lin's performance in The Greatest Showman has never looked clearer in HDR on a Sony projector. However, this tweak also has the unwanted side effect of making near-black posterization more obvious in HDR mode. Curious, we ran some near-black quantization test patterns on the Sony VPL-VW760ES. And saw very harsh transitions on specific ones, as if the color depth was lower than 8-bit. The coarse gradation would shift as we toggle between picture modes, or even engaged smooth gradation, but it was always present in HDR mode. Interestingly, we put up an SDR quantization pattern and the problem went away, suggesting that the low bit depth only affected HDR content. Until Sony addresses this issue, owners may want to consider watching HDR content in SDR instead, since proper HDR presentation is very challenging on any projectors anyway, even one as bright and stable as the Sony VW760ES. If you still prefer to watch HDR on the VW760, know that the HDR reference setting is optimized for 1000 nit content, whereas the HDR10 setting is designed to retain more specular highlight detail for 4000 nit movies. Otherwise, our review sample calibrated superbly, allowing us to obtain an average delta error of less than 1 in this demanding color checker SG chart where 140 color patches were measured. As a result, general colors including skin tones looked impressively accurate, although like all Sony projectors to date, the VW760 or VW885 still applied a very mild degree of noise reduction, which can only be completely switched off by engaging input lag reduction. Overall, the latest firmware of 8.102 added some useful features to the VW760ES 4K laser projector, but we strongly urge Sony to look into the HDR near-black polarization that's more apparent following the firmware update. If you have found this video useful, please click the like button and subscribe to the HDTV Test YouTube channel for more videos like this. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.